So the Dark Eyes is basically a tabletop game that was released in Germany in 1984 by Schmidt Spiele and Freizeit or something like that. I don't think the original company is with us anymore, but a lot of companies actually release game for this universe. That's nice painting. So you probably remember the River of Time, Drakensang, and the Philosopher's Secret. I'll call it the Philosopher's Secret. And it's a traditional RPG with a lot of interesting mechanics. Now, I created my character. He's a human who has a little bit of a fancy for the dark arts. Sorry, I didn't create a character in plain sight, but it takes a long, long time. And besides, I was not sure what I was doing. So, we are a researcher, human researcher, profession blessed one of Boron. So, let's just play some normal gameplay, because I guess that's what people want to see. So, I actually got stuck on this stupid portion of the map for a long, long time. Just because of the way they choose to do it, so. A dagger? Are you using a dagger? Well, I guess a dagger is okay to kill rats, but it's a little messy. So it's basically a dice roll. So as you can see, we're kind of missing our attacks, but oh, the enemy hit us for a big chunk of damage. Okay, let's just move on forward. Yeah, you can listen to the door, you can do some other things as well. But for now, let's just focus on completing the tutorial so we can get into the meat and potatoes of the game. Or the dessert of the game, which is kind of like Kremschmidt or something like that, I don't know. So yeah, when I played those games, it was actually amazing. So they are like full-fledged RPG with all the systems that you expect. Crafting, more people in the party, dwarves, elves, magic. A good story. The only thing that I didn't like about those games, they were a little short. And it was just like the Witcher experience. I over-farmed for them and in the end I had too many items, too much stuff. Here we have a map. Okay, did we equip our mace? Yeah, or Warhammer, or whatever that thing is. Starting to get worried, we are taking so much damage. Apparently you can fail the tutorial for some weird reason. That's in the game design. No, I'll not use a health potion, I want to survive this. So you also have the rest ability. Which is exactly what you expect it to be, it rests. Come on, there's some more, you're not fully healed. Do some more campfire stories. Okay, so we can also find some items in the shelves, but I think they're all empty except for this one. Yeah, the graphics are quite fine and am I doing? Don't do that. If I press escape again, it will not cancel the menu, so that's why I'm a bit conflicted. Okay, so this is where I got stuck. You see that thing over there? It actually leads out of the dungeon, but you don't see the little thing. Okay, the game wants me to do another thing. Well, okay, let's just do the other objective. One thing I really don't appreciate is that the tutorial doesn't really help you. I keep pressing escape because that's the normal way to do it. Developers should really learn from things like this. Okay, let's just search everything in here. Oh, okay. This is an interesting room. I see undead. Or undead people, or dead people to be more precise. Only bones remain. We're also on a mission to kind of throw... We're basically on a mission as a vigilante to expose the governor of this town, which is plagued by orc attacks. So what happened to these adventurers? Did they not have any loot on them? Did they come here unprepared? Sure, but first of all, okay, I wanted to steal everything, but let's talk to the goblin. Rust belt, oh, let's not insult him, so let's make him help us. That actually worked, well, that's a very rare occurrence when you just ask for the thing you need and you get it. That's a nice table. So I don't know many things about the game, but we'll figure them out as we play. Oh, I keep pressing that escape button. So not much to see for now, but I think the maps get dark if you complete the section. I mean, the sections get dark if you complete them. Ah, precious light and freedom. This is what I've been expecting. So I got 5 action points. I didn't find any beauty. So you actually have some modifiers. You get 1 action point for each work of art acquired during the adventure. That's my bonus. I could also make it so I gain action points based on the money and some other stuff. So this is in a way like Hand of Fate. No, I want... Wait, Spear of Ice. Oh, it actually costs 4... Okay, I understand. So, improvement cost is over there. I don't know what that means, but... I hope it's a good thing. By the way, we're kind of like an inquisitor, so that's why I choose it like this. So I guess it will be a randomly generated. How about if I join a game? Are people playing this? Wait a minute, I have to see. So yeah, this is exactly as I imagined. It's a procedurally generated world. It's more like a little... I don't know how to call it. It's like Deep Rock Galactic, or you join other people in missions and do stuff, but it's only an RPG, so I guess we'll find elves, dwarves and some other stuff. Red level 1. I like undead. LAN. We have a LAN party, friends only. To be honest, I don't know much about this particular game, but... Okay, let's leave that, because I want to start the adventure. White mage, human, rogue dwarf. You are coming with me. So what are you supposed... The white mage is coming with me, of course. Wandering sword. Are you an archer? Because I really need an archer. Bow 6. Okay, let's continue. I don't really care about the other stuff, so you can play multiplayer or single player.
You step into the caverns and squint into the darkness until your eyes adjust. The smell of decay and rot gets stronger the further you venture in.
I guess they're only my henchmen and I can't control them, so what about the chance? Sure, let's see if we can find everything so I don't have to control everything myself. Oh, gold astral, I guess that's okay. A dead bandit. Well, dead bandits are a good thing generally, but in this case, I think... Okay, that was kind of bad. Let's rest for a little bit. What happened? Did that explode on me? Okay, I have to remember to do that as well. Oh, the map generation is beautiful. Yeah, it looks like they actually made a lot of systems very, very simplified just because they wanted a more tactical approach to the game and a more fun one. And by that I mean they actually reduced a lot of the mechanics that were before in the game. But I'm not sure what to say about this title, I have to play it more to see. Miner and dead ban what? Did he do something really bad? Why did you ban him? Okay, so that might alert the enemy, so I guess there is some kind of a drawback to it. Okay, let's choose to rest. There is also quite a delay in the mechanic of the resting. I can't do anything while this is happening. The settings are quite nice, as you can see it's the highest. Resolution is okay, everything seems to be in order. I mean, it's exactly what I expected. Instead, I expected more variety. This area is particularly safe. Why? Because it has a campfire? I feel like this will be a very heavy combat zone. I guess this would be a lot more fun in multiplayer, but who has friends who play German RPGs or German late 80s RPGs, to be more precise? Oh, thank you, Elf. Did you just do something over here? Turquoise, okay. I don't know what that elf is doing, but I hope it doesn't go off into battle. Plus, I have a lot of skill checks like lore and nature and some other stuff. That looks like a dangerous zone. Well, I see a campfire. That means we can rest here a little bit. Okay, let's see how long it takes before this button appears over here to cancel it. Yeah, I'm a bit disappointed that it's not as good or as well implemented as the other games, and it's kind of simplistic in the menu and the equipment, and you have to play randomly generated missions. But to be honest, it looks cool and it plays, at least until this point, kind of nice. Can't complain too much about it either. Just wish I had an archer or two archers. Come on, attack him. So yeah, this is turn-based even though it doesn't look like it. Okay, then just use your skill then. Semi and fire. some bugs here and there. I don't know, I couldn't move on that side, so let's just go and rest. I'll think I'll finish the mission and then I'll end the video if I can help it. So she has mana, so that means she can use spells. Also, the rest is automatically over. This could make a nice thumbnail for the video. See? Maybe I should have used the disarm option while I was doing that. Yeah, it's like, okay, it's exactly as I imagined, that elf is only trouble, the elves are only trouble. Did she just use up one of my potions? Okay, let's just rest here on the spot, let's not continue any further. This is looking like it's not such a great game after all, because of it's kind of simplified and the mechanics are more randomized than I wanted. I mean, not randomized, but the mission are randomized. Okay, we'll play it, we'll give it a chance. I mean, I love the other game, so why not? These silly zombies are actually guarding the bandit corpses. That's actually a very good skill to have. Okay, that was decent. We kind of cleared an entire area. Why does it show I can go? Oh, it. Okay, it makes it darker after you leave the area. I can leave map markers, okay. The game seems to have a lot of systems in place, so I guess this will be a very fun co-op game if you play it with friends or if you, I don't know, want to create your own custom character and actually survive the battles with him. But for now it's kind of stingy with the details, so I didn't know any of this before I played the game. That's a huge range. Okay, let's only use you to kill the undead. I can't pass this point and I don't know why. Very weird, I'm starting to lose faith in the game, but let's try again. So it says I can go there, but I can't go there. What am I missing over here? Can I do something? No idea why that worked or what I just did over there with the protective barrier, but let's take things at face value. Oh, these skeletons are dead skeletons, I got it. I thought they were alive skeletons, but no. Dead as they get. Wait a minute, is this a secret room? Okay, let's just do this mission. Sorry, I'm so confused, but this is one of the games that doesn't really give you any information if you're doing things the right way or the wrong way. Also need to rest to recover the key. No. Let's not fight the... Let's fight the... I wanted to say, let's not fight them without actually having all the mana or key points available to us. That's so buggy. Hit him. Hit the elf. Or the sorceress or whatever that is. Look at that guy fighting all those zombies. 3 zombies. Yeah, no problem for him. He is a professional zombie slayer and also an inquisitor trained under me. Why am I doing 0 damage? What's going on? Okay, backstab attack. Also, you also get a dungeon key from the guy. Okay, let's rest. And then we'll recover all, I mean... Tether Gaze didn't play like this, so let's give it one more chance. I'll probably do another episode on the game because it's still interesting to me. Even with all the bugs and the little problems so far, well, maybe I'm missing something. Maybe this was a mobile game before, I don't know. Can you pass through that thing over there? Okay, the doors are over here. Don't care, we are leaving. We are leaving. Yes, let's end the adventure. That was kind of... Oh, Restless Caverns. I got an achievement for this. Trap, Sage. Kind of step into a trap. Magical lore plus 1 karma points. Let's select the magic lore for now. Oh, so that's the threat level number 2. That's the mission that I kind of have to go. Okay, let's see some of the other things that are around here. The stash. Why would they give me a stash when I barely have one item to equip or two? Don't tell me we have crafting. If we have crafting, we have crafting. Well, I at least expected a lot more. I mean, we should be able to do a lot more stuff with our inventory, not just equip a piece of armor and a weapon. Okay, so that side of the tavern is not available to me. Well, I guess I really have to play the game more to actually see what happens, because it might be complicated, it might be a little better. This is what the Dark Eye is. Okay, I hope you read that. Or paused at it. Let's see what the fortune teller tells us. Oh, so this is all the cards I have so far. I think that's the gold and I don't know what that is. Maybe the KP points? This is the trader armor and stuff. Also, in this universe, spellcasters have problems casting their spells when they touch iron, so they shouldn't touch iron at all. Seems fairly diverse. We have bows, maces, quarterstaff, shields, knives, knuckle dusters. Warara, I don't know what that is. Also bear traps and arrows and arax and 100%. The leather armor is actually very, very bad for a mage. I don't know what type of character my character is, but he looks like he wants to cast some spells. So, the gold dust is actually pretty expensive. Okay, the old tiara. So far, so good. Oh, the little axes are kind of like a mini game on themselves. Henchmen. Also, I can hire all of them. I guess that's only for multiplayer. Anyway, that's kind of it for now. Maybe I'll play more of the game to see how it is, but you kind of have the general idea of the game right now. That's a dagger. And that's a raven's beak. Or bec du corban in French. Anyway, it's kind of a little fantasy-like. See you next time. Bye!